Lannister, Targaryen, Baratheon, Stark, Tyrell. They're all just spokes on a wheel. This one's on top, then that one's on top, and on it spins, crushing those on the ground.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back for another Game of Thrones Season 8 video. Today I will be talking about some things that need to happen in order for Game of Thrones to have a good ending, or even just a decent ending at the least. The title of the video says the best way to end Game of Thrones. What I mean by that is, what makes sense, not what just would look cool cinematically. We all know they brought back Miguel Sapochnik to direct their battle scene, so I'm not concerned with how it will look visually. I'm sure that will be fantastic, but I'm more concerned about the storytelling. I think most of us can agree that this is one aspect of the show where they have been lacking in the last few seasons now that they no longer have the books to go off of. Last week I made a video talking about the worst ways to end the show. Before I made that video, I reached out to several different YouTubers and I got their opinions on the topic as well. I wanted to get several different perspectives because my own opinion alone may have came off as biased. I want to do the same thing for this video, so I reached out to a few different YouTubers again. In order for Game of Thrones to have a good ending, several things will need to happen, but I only asked each of them to give me one answer, that way I can include several different scenarios or possibilities. You may or may not agree with some of these ideas, but that's alright. The comment section will be open for debate, so feel free to leave your opinions as well. Now let's begin. The first answer comes from Robert, and his YouTube channel is called In Deep Geek. Robert says, not only should this happen, but this must happen. We need to learn more about the White Walkers and the Night King. Why have they returned? Why now? What do they want? If we don't get those answers, then they are basically just a bunch of ice zombies that need to be killed, and that has been done many times before. I couldn't agree any more with Robert's answer. That's actually why I wanted to use his first, because I had this at the top of my own list. We were introduced to the White Walkers in the opening scene of the pilot episode, yet we still don't know much about them or their motives. George has always said he never wanted to create characters that were black or white, and that goes for the White Walkers too. With that in mind, they can't be as evil as they are portrayed to be. I just hope the television show goes in the same direction. I do not want them to be operating as machines that only deliver death. There needs to be a good reason for why they are doing this, and why they are doing this now. This leads me to what the next person said because it's very similar. PhilTheIssuesGuy said, for Dan and Dave to be inspired to adapt George's outline for the conclusion, they will need the same passion they had at the beginning of the series. That way we can have a great ending. For me, it's really just to understand the White Walker's motivation. They should not be a hollow adversary whose motivations are never revealed. They need to create more depth. Also, I think this is a hard one. It needs to surprise me. It should not be something that's easily predictable. If the ending is coming from George, then it's the last piece we're going to get from him that could be considered as a hint in the show for how the books will end. So I just hope it's something we can't even possibly imagine. This is a great answer, Phil, and I think this is one of the downsides of this show becoming so popular. There are millions of people trying to guess how the series will end, and whenever someone comes up with a good idea, it spreads like wildfire on the internet, and eventually someone will get it right. The White Walker's motivations may not come as a surprise because one of us may have already predicted their motives, but I would be pleased as long as we get some kind of an answer. But of course, this isn't the only thing that needs to happen in order for Game of Thrones to have a good ending. Now I want to show you what GrayArea had to say. GrayArea said she needs to see Nymeria's wolf pack fight in the Great War. For those of you who know Grey, you should already know she's Team Direwolf all the way. Hashtag Free Ghost. I think most of you would agree with this. The Direwolves are completely underused, when we all know they should be with their owners at all times. Ghost should follow Jon around like he's his shadow, and the same with Nymeria and Arya. Unfortunately, Arya had to run Nymeria off, or else Cersei would have had her killed. But we do know that Nymeria is still alive, and she has formed her own army of direwolves. Now that the White Walkers are making their way south, it's only a matter of time before the Great War begins. When this happens, Nymeria should sense that Arya may be in trouble. Even though Arya can't handle herself, but you know what I mean. It would be amazing if Nymeria and 100 other wolves showed up on the battlefield and just started ripping whites apart. I would definitely love to see that. This is their last chance to involve the direwolves. There are no more seasons after this, so they better go out with a bang by having the wolves get some more kills under their collars. Alright, so this next one comes from Tony Teflon from Teflon TV. Tony says, "In order for Game of Thrones to end well, I need to see Daenerys Targaryen die. I don't think you can have her get what she wants just because of her name. I think she needs to learn the lessons that Stannis and Jon learned. Both of them died for their cause, and Daenerys should too." Tony's response is very interesting. This has been a hot debate lately because many people theorize that Daenerys will die during childbirth, or she will fulfill the Nisa Nisa prophecy, which means a sword will be plunged through her heart. I should also mention that as far as I know, Tony was the very first person to make a theory video about Daenerys being Nisa Nisa. I think he made that video about 3 or 4 years ago, and in that video he breaks down some of the text from the books that may indicate Daenerys will die this way. You should definitely watch that video. Tony certainly isn't the only person who feels this way, which leads me to Kevin's response to this question. Kevin has a YouTube channel called BattProductions, and he said, "In order for Game of Thrones to have a decent ending, there has to be a lot of death to some of the characters we don't want to see go. Think of your three favorite characters. Two of them have to die. One will remain to inspire hope for the story to continue on, for rebuilding the human race. Specifically, Daenerys must make the ultimate sacrifice with her life to save Westeros as she promised for many seasons, albeit not in the way that she planned. Poor Tyrion Lannister, the misunderstood and mistreated dwarf, will also have to die, giving his life to a greater cause. Cersei and Jaime will meet their ends tragically together. Jon Snow must remain intact as a non-White Walker because he's been through the nightmare of death and is the character we must all get behind to hope for a better tomorrow. Lastly, Westeros must rebuild from the ashes with no family lines established. What will be needed though is for another Aegon, meaning Jon, to unite the country once again to prosper. As for the other minor characters, I'm sure most of them will meet their deaths as a result of the impending conflict, but some characters, like Arya, should continue their exploration beyond." I think Kevin makes some very good points in terms of how many favorite characters should die. They shouldn't kill people off just for shock value, but they also can't allow people to live just to avoid backlash either. Whoever they decide to kill off needs to make sense narratively. I agree with some of our favorite characters dying. I'm not just talking about second tier characters either, like Tormund or Beric. But I mean people like Jaime, Cersei, Euron, and some of the big ones from the north. They could kill Jon again, although it wouldn't make much sense, but I won't be surprised if they did. I have also said that I could see Daenerys dying in the end. I definitely think that's possible, but for some reason, whenever I say that, people always assume that means I want her to die, which couldn't be any further from the truth. Daenerys could live for 1,000 years and I wouldn't give two shits unless she was meant to die, which it has been foreshadowed in previous seasons, although some people refuse to accept that. I think her visions at the House of the Undying made that pretty clear, and Tyrion's conversation about keeping the wheel broken after Dany's death seemed a little telling too, but I guess we're gonna have to wait and see how that plays out. What I'm really looking forward to the most is what they decide to do with the White Walkers and the Night King. I've always been fascinated by the others, and I'm dying to know what their plans exactly are. We know they've been active for many years, but something has caused them to start to move in force very recently, and I need to know what that is. I would be very disappointed if their goal was to only wipe out humanity. They've allowed too many people to live for me to believe they only want everyone dead. Just like Robert said at the beginning of the video, that has been done too many times. It can't just be good versus evil. There are many other aspects of this story I'm hoping they get right, but with only 6 episodes left, there might not be enough time to wrap everything up in a nice bow. But I am hoping for the best. Comment down below and let me know what you need to see happen in order for you to consider it to be a good ending. Do you agree with anything that was said in today's video? Or do you have some other examples you would like to point out? Or do you disagree with any of the responses I've shown you today? I would love to hear your opinions on this topic. I want to thank all the YouTubers that participated. I will put the links to their channels down below, that way you can check out their channels and videos. I also have to thank everyone for watching and those of you who support the channel on Patreon. I really appreciate that, and I hope you have a great day. I will see you in the next one. Bye.